Hello, people of the internet, this is Kaiju Noir here with another Tag Year Id video. Yes, folks, we're doing this again. Recently, Matt Burkett of the Monstrosities channel started another tag trend, where one asks 5 questions to 4 YouTubers, who must answer said questions and make 5 new ones for 4 more YouTubers. As a result, I've been tagged by Titan Goji, whose channel I highly recommend. Now without further ado, let's get this show on the road! Number 1. What's your favorite Godzilla monster? If you've been following my channel for a while, you should know by now that my favorite Godzilla monster is none other than Titanosaurus, the aquatic dinosaur from the final film in the Showa series, Terror of Mechagodzilla. Back in 2019, I made a video discussing my top 15 favorite giant monsters in fiction, not counting the Big G himself. So if you'd like to know why Titanosaurus is my favorite monster in general, I recommend checking that video out. Number 2. What's your favorite non-Godzilla tokusatsu series? If I had to choose one, it would have to be the Ultraman series. Among the 3 most popular tokusatsu franchises, those being Super Sentai, Kamen Rider, and Ultraman, Tsuburaya's Cavalcade of Silver Giants caters the most towards my personal taste in tokusatsu entertainment. That being pure kaiju carnage with a heaping helping of superheroic beatdowns. Not to mention that among the big 3, Ultraman has remained the most consistent franchise in terms of overall quality. Even with shows like Ultraman X and Ultraman Z that do contain the same toy commercial aesthetic that has plagued modern toku shows, you can tell that Tsuburaya still puts enough love and care into their stories, characters, and action, resulting in a product that feels both fun and genuine. Number 3. What's your favorite kaiju movie? It would easily be Ghidorah the Three-Headed Monster. As a child, I always rooted for Godzilla, whether or not he was the actual good guy in his films. So when it came to the 1964 classic, it always excited me whenever I got to see my favorite fictional character of all time officially take on the mantle as a defender of the Earth. In the grand scheme of things, this was the film that started the trend of portraying Godzilla in a protagonistic role where he would take a stand against threats far too great for the people of Earth to tackle, either on his own or alongside his allies, which is certainly the case here. How can you go wrong with a film that has 3 of Toho's most popular characters unite against one of the franchise's most iconic villains, King Ghidorah? On top of that, you have a thrilling human plot involving mystery, suspense, and action, involving an alien-possessed princess, international assassins, twin fairies, and an apocalyptic prophecy that may or may not come to pass. What more could you ask for in a Godzilla flick? For me personally, this film hits all the right spots to make it my favorite Godzilla film and my favorite kaiju movie of all time. Number 4. What is your ideal Godzilla movie? That's certainly a tough one, as I never considered what I would prefer in a Godzilla film, especially when there are so many variants of the character that I enjoy. I suppose if I were to choose a version of Godzilla that I prefer the most, it would have to be the approach taken with the early to mid Showa series. In a typical Godzilla movie from the 60s, characters inhabit a heightened reality where monsters, aliens, and advanced technology are the norm. It's a world that mixes elements of both sci-fi and fantasy, a world where nobody questions the absurdity of the situation, as the writers fully embrace the story's campy nature with a tone that contains just the right amount of seriousness without being too cynical. Speaking of cynicism, as an adult, I've grown to appreciate the lack of said attitude in terms of the overall message of unity that Ishiro Honda conveyed, as the people in these films would often set aside their differences in the hopes of achieving a greater cause, something I felt Pacific Rim did a better job at than any other modern Godzilla movie to date. So if I were to have an ideal Godzilla film, it would be in a similar vein as the works of Ishiro Honda and his legendary crew. Number 5. Are you Team Godzilla or Team Kong? Ah yes, I knew this was gonna come up eventually as we approached Godzilla vs. Kong's release. Well, normally I'd be backing the King of the Monsters as a lifelong Godzilla fan, but ever since a certain panel at G-Fest in which my boy D-Man1954 was booed for backing the 8th wonder of the world,
and yet I openly root for Kong to win in 2020. I understand.
I think supporting Team Kong is the way to go. You're not alone in this anymore, Derek! Plus, Kong has had a major influence on me, almost as much as Godzilla, so I'd be happy backing either character any day. But in all seriousness, I won't be upset nor excited if one of them wins or loses, as I'm more concerned with whether or not this film is actually good. For me, it's the story that ultimately matters the most. Now here's the part where I tag the following YouTubers for my 5 questions, those being Dylan McCandless, aka SuperDM64, and Shoma, Crookin' Lore, and...
All this time I spent answering Andres' bullshit questions, I could have been doing something constructive! Three cronies pressured me into doing it. I decided, I am going to masturbate. Yes!
Yes!
Gorizard. As for the questions, here they are. Number 1. Which tokusatsu franchise would you like to see get an animated adaptation? Number 2. What are your thoughts on Hasbro's Power Rangers no longer relying on Super Sentai stock footage? Number 3. What piece of Japanese media would you like to see get an American release? Number 4. Where do you see the Godzilla franchise going post Godzilla vs. Kong? And number 5. What are some of your favorite giant robots in fiction? Here are my answers to these questions. Seeing Godzilla, Ultraman, and especially Gridman receive the animation treatment, I like the same done for either Super Sentai or Power Rangers, especially in the case of the Teenagers with Attitude, if it's an adaptation of the Boom comics or the Justice League crossover. Heck, if Batman vs. Ninja Turtles got a movie, why not them? Speaking of Power Rangers, I was genuinely surprised when Hasbro announced they were severing their ties with Toei in order to produce their own 100% fully original Power Rangers. I do think that it's possible that with the right talent, direction, time, and budget, a fully American-produced Power Rangers can work. However, given the iffy track record larger studios have when it comes to the budgets of the Marvel and DC shows, it's very possible we'll end up with a series with very little action, subpar CG, and a lot of interpersonal drama. In regards to Japanese media in need of a stateside release, I would love for the manga adaptations of the 80s and 90s Godzilla films to finally be localized. The only one that most older fans would be familiar with would be the adaptation of Godzilla 1984, which was not only translated, but also colorized and released by Dark Horse as a 6-issue miniseries called Terror of Godzilla. As for the rest of the books, the closest I and many other fans have gotten to reading them would be the few snippets of fan-translated sequences on Toho Kingdom, as well as a few chapters of Godzilla vs. Space Godzilla floating around on the internet. By giving these books an official English release, Western fans would finally have the chance to see and appreciate a brand new take on these familiar stories, both in terms of the art and writing. Sadly, it may be an uphill battle for any potential US publisher, since IDW at one point tried getting the localization rights, only to be met with a massive roadblock. Due to Japanese copyright laws, they'd have to track every creator involved and get their approval, as each of them holds the rights to their work. Hey, at least it's better than how Marvel and DC treat their creators, am I right? For the future of Godzilla post-GBK, I don't see the franchise going live action anytime soon, at least not in America. The global pandemic has put a halt to the majority of films in Hollywood, especially the large-scale tentpole blockbusters. That plus it's uncertain if GBK can be profitable through a simultaneous release for both HBO Max and movie theaters. Though I can't imagine Toho making films again if the situation in Japan improves. If not, Godzilla Singular Point could be the sign of things to come. Finally, to answer my very last question, my choices would be Draco Azul from Primal Warrior Draco Azul number 1, Draco Azul from Primal Warrior Draco Azul number 2, and who am I forgetting? Draco Azul from Primal Warrior Draco Azul Full Metal Chronicles, all available on Amazon and Comixology. So, Joking aside, if you want to know my actual favorite mechs, you can check out my Top 15 Giant Robots video I made back in 2015. Thank you very much everybody for watching, and a huge thanks to Titan Goji for including me in the series. As for the people I tagged, have fun you guys! So until next time everybody, take care!
Hello, this is the editor that Andres hired for this video, Davis, aka Titan Goji, and
don't tell Andres, but I'm secretly using this video to promote my TeePublic, because I got a TeePublic.
I'll show you. Yeah, look at all that. Yeah, these are all new designs of my own creation. Got some Ultraman, some Kamen Rider, got Ultraman Peter Griffin, got some masks too. Team Godzilla, Team Kong. I'm a Team Kong guy myself. Got some Gundam stuff too. I'm wearing this mask right now, and Andres actually bought some of this stuff. So yeah, got a lot more. Hope y'all dig it. And remember to purchase Primal Warrior Draco Azul issues 1 and 2, as well as the anthology novel
Full Metal Chronicles. I think that's like the only way he'll let me get away with this. So, yeah. Take it easy, y'all.